Pressure cooker contains, what is 1.5 kg of saturated steam. So 1.5 kg of that is saturated steam. So yeah, pressure cooker contains 1.5 kg of saturated steam at 5 bar. This is the first condition. At 5 bar. Then find the quantity of heat must be rejected. Quantity of heat, that is ideal heat in terms of Q, which must be rejected as to reduce the quality to 60 degrees Celsius, as reduce the quality, that is a quality is what is nothing but quality. Quality of steam in so long. Quality to 60% dry.
Dryness.
Quality to 60% dry. So X is 60% dry. Okay, then determine the pressure and temperature of the steam at the new state. Determine pressure and the temperature of steam at a new state. That is, new state is nothing but that is 60% dry. So listen, here in the problem, initially you having a pressure cooker. Listen, so pressure cooker is nothing but the closed vessel. So volume remains constant. Okay, volume remains constant. So initially at the first condition, having a mass that is a 1.5 kg of saturated steam. 1.5 kg of, that is the saturated steam, that is present in the boiler. So M is equal to, that is 1.5 kg at saturated steam. You know that condition. So 1.5 kg, which is equal to mass at saturated steam. This is a fluid with the steam having a mass of 1.5 kg at the first condition is saturated condition. Then second, you know that find the quantity of heat must be rejected. If the saturated steam is, we have the same mass, okay, you are having a same mass, but at condition is 60% dry. The condition is 60% dry. So listen, so at that condition, what about the condition for the first condition? What about the X at the first condition? So what about the X at the first condition?
100% vapor, 0% liquid.
100% vapor, so we can say X is equal to 1. Equal to 0.6. So from reducing X from 0.1 to 0, heat is to be rejected. That is our problem. Okay. So at first condition, M is equal to 1.5 kg. At a saturation condition, it reduces to 0.6. Then, how much amount of heat is to be reduced? This is your problem. So, how much heat is reduced? It is nothing but it is a partial volume system. So, you can say that the heat reduced is nothing but internal energy lost. So, initially, we are having internal energy U1, and if it allows the heat to, because it is reduced to U2. We can also heat in the enthalpy than a particular. But in the internal energy in the soldering up, here no heat is added to the system. In the system, we have to add the heat to the system. Or heat add to the system, we have to add heat. So the molecule tends to reduce the heat. So if it is in the molecular heat, we can say it is nothing but the enthalpy. It is nothing but the enthalpy. If you have a problem, internal energy. It is nothing but the internal energy. But suppose we heat na may add panna, abhi na may enthalpy term ko na, but naman heat engi use panna pordo kariya the. Ulla store ayer heat na matada very varde. So stored heat is nothing but the internal energy. So definition of the internal energy is nothing but the heat energy stored within the molecule. It is internal energy. Enthalpy is nothing but the total heat of the system. So you have energy store panning loss aagum kekkranga. So u1 to u2 or u1 minus u2, that is e, which is equal to, that is u1 minus u2, the formula. So idha nama kandupidikkanum. So at initial condition you have to find what is u. So what is u? First nee kandupidikka vendiyathu what is u kandupidikkum. So listen, what is the formula for u in terms of h and p? What is u? In initial condition, u1 is equal to eppadi eludalam?
H is equal to u plus
h1 minus, that is the p1 v1. This is the formula. So listen, that is at a 5 bar. 5 bar level. Okay, va. Chali. Ipa how you can find a h1? At what position you find the h1? H1 gari enga kandupidipa steam table la?
Five bar pressure, sir.
Very good. So at a five bar pressure, listen. So at five bar. So what is that one? The one number point. In the condition there. One number point. In the condition there.
Saturated steam.
Saturated steam. अपन saturated steam अब बिंग करना ला. Saturated vapor करना ला. That one इप्परी इल्ल ना. In terms of H. Saturated vapor and saturated steam table. உதாரணத்துக்கு இங்க steam table. So this is a 3D diagram. So that is, this is nothing but the saturated vapor line. What is the name of the line? The name எப்படி denote பண்ணலாம் இந்த லைனை? இது இந்த லைனை எப்படி denote பண்ணலாம்?
Saturated liquid க்கு saturated vapor க்கு.
இது saturated liquid க்கு இது saturated vapor க்கு இது எப்படி எழுதலாம்? In terms of notation எழுதறப்போ it can be written in terms of hg. இந்த லைனுக்கு பேர் என்னன்னா g லைன். இந்த லைனுக்கு பேர் என்னது? f லைன். மறந்துடவே கூடாது, சரியா? So this is represented as hg line, sorry g line. Here it is represented as f line. So அப்ப 1ங்கற பாயிண்ட் வந்து எந்த எந்த லைன்ல வருது? saturated steam அப்படினு சொன்னதனால எந்த கண்டிஷன்ல வருது?
g லைன் சார்.
g லைன். g லைன்ல வந்து h1 is equal to hg. அதே மாதிரி பார்த்தனா v1 is equal to vg. Then at the point you note that what is the value of h of g. Steam table is aligned with that one, and then you note the condition, that is what is the saturation temperature. So you note the following points from the steam table. So steam table la enna pandrom eduthrom, seriya? Okay, ipo na inda screen fit pandren. Listen, enoda so first one is saturation water temperature table. So we are no need to take a temperature because in the problem the pressure is given. You directly go to the saturated pressure table, to saturated water steam and pressure table. So in the problem the data given is of 5 bar. So at 5 bar you take the respective values. So first one is saturation temperature. We are having the value. Okay, just wait. We are having the values. Is that you note that? So hg is equal to how? What is the value of hg? Come on, answer. From the steam table at a 5 bar, what is the value of hg? So this is equal to 2747.5. Don't forget to write the, sorry, forget to write the unit. So properly you should be write written unit at anywhere. The next one is the VG. What is the value of VG? 0.37466. So here there is a meter cube divided by there is a kilogram. Then next one, what is the HFG? What is the value of HFG?
2107.4
kilogram. Then we are having a saturation temperature. What about the saturation temperature? At a 5 bar, what is the saturation temperature? At 5 bar, what is the saturation temperature? 151.8 because here in the pressure table, so here is a pressure value given for the corresponding pressure, you are having a saturation temperature. So we are having the, that is equal to 151.8 is nothing but the saturation temperature, that is degree Celsius. Okay, now we move on to the whiteboard screen. From the steam table, we take that value of corresponding V, H and etc. Then you are going to find what about the initial condition, that is what about the initial internal energy. So from that formula, U1 is equal to, listen, then U1 is equal to H1, that is already I told what is H1 for the corresponding condition, what is the H1? H1 is equal to, so what is
HG?
HG, that is 47.5 minus, what about the pressure? Pressure is equal to 5, it can be written as bar, then V. So what is the V1? What is V1?
VG.
So 0.37466 meter cube divided by kilogram. So for the conversion of multiplication of pressure and volume, what is the unit conversion basically we followed? So 2747.5, here the unit is nothing but, there is a kilojoule per, say nothing but kilogram. So minus per kilogram, now bar into meter cube per kilogram. Is it possible to convert the meter cube bar into meter cube per kilogram? Here it is a bar, here it is meter cube per kilogram. How it is cancelled? So what is the way to cancel each other?
Sir, bar can be converted.
Bar can be converted into kilonewton per meter square into meter cube divided by kilogram. So now already I told 1 bar is equal to how much? 1 bar is equal to
10^2 kilonewton
per meter.
1 bar is equal to 10^5 newton per meter square. So it can be right in terms of kilo. So which is equal to 10^2 say 2 kilonewton per meter square, 10^2 kilonewton per meter square. So listen, here the meter square meter cancelled. So finally, you can be right, there is a kilonewton meter divided by kilogram. What is newton meter? What is newton meter?
Joule.
So it is equal to, that can be written as, say it is nothing but kilojoule per, say that is kilogram. So we can write, that is 5 × 10^2, because bar can be written in terms of kilonewton per meter square, then into, that is 0.37466. Finally, for the both the term, you get the unit that is nothing but kilojoule per kilogram. So by multiplying using a calculator, finally you get the value of U1 is equal to, if anybody have a calculator, please work out and say the answer.
2560.17, sir.
2560, very good. That is a 2560.17. 17.
Kilojoule.
So kilojoule per kilogram. That is the initial condition, initial internal energy of steam, that the initial condition of steam that internal energy have. Then we are going to find in condition at 2. So first condition you already find out, and now we are going to find the second condition. Okay, so how I can find the second condition? Because in a pressure cooker, please listen, in a pressure cooker, the volume remains same. The volume are no need to take a steam out from the system. So the pressure, the system is completely closed. No steam that comes out from the system to surroundings. So the volume remains stable. Volume remains stable. Okay. Now we can find what about the volume of the system. So at that condition, you find what about the volume of the system. So how we can find the volume? So volume V1 is equal to, how we write the volume? V1 is equal to, I can write V1 if I, that is, I told the same concept in the first problem of this unit.
Vf plus x into Vfg.
No. Yeah, that's correct. Vf plus x into Vfg. But here Vf is given, x is given, Vfg is already given. But in another formula, we are having such simple formula that is available for find out the volume. That is the volume, there is a capital V. Specific volume.
Volume by unit mass.
Volume by unit mass. So volume is equal to.
Specific volume into unit
mass into specific volume. That's the thing. Yeah.
Specific volume.
So volume is equal to mass at the condition there is specific volume one. So already we are having a mass. What about the mass of the steam present inside the cooker? From the given data, what is the mass of steam? So this is equal to 1.5 kg at a specific condition. That is the V1. So at the condition number one, what is the condition of a steam? At point number one, what is the condition of steam?
Saturated steam.
Saturated. So V1 can be written as, that is equal to another Vg. So Vg from the table, you note that that is 0.374466. Here you can be written as meter cube per kilogram. So kilogram, kilogram can cancel. Finally, what is the value of V1? The value of V1.
0.56
something. I don't know exactly what is the answer. 0.56 56. Come on. 56. Enna kana varo?
56199,
sir.
56199. Simply can be written as 562 meter cube. Yeah, and some I have answer like that. That is 0.562 something meter cube. So there may be variation because of taking a decimal up to 4 digit or 5 digit. There may be variation. So here the volume at a condition one is equal to 0.56199 meter cube. Then next we move on to the state two. Listen, so state one volume is equal to state two because the volume never changes because no steam is taken out from the cooker or system. So now we move on to the, that is the V1 is equal to, so V2, because volume remains same, there is no, we never take any mass from the cooker. So V1, at a condition V1 is nothing but saturated condition, we already find V1. So what about the V2? So here pressure cooker, initial condition, that is condition number one, but condition number two, listen. So at condition number one, x is equal to one, but here x is equal to 0.6. Here x1 is equal to one, otherwise x2 is equal to 0.6. So how we can write V2? So V2 can be written as, that is the mass into, we can write the specific volume at two. Mass into specific volume at 2, V2. Are you okay? Everybody get to understand?
Sir.
Yes. So V2 can be written as, that is a mass into specific volume 2. Now we can write mass into, at V2, what is the condition at 2? So condition at 2, x is equal to 0.6. How we can write a small V2? Specific volume, yeah. How we can write? At a condition of, very good. Come on, answer V.
Vf plus x2 into Vfg.
Very good. Vf plus x2 into
Vfg.
Vf?
Vfg, sir.
Vfg2. This is the formula. Okay. Then, we are having a formula, expanding the formula. M into, listen, Vf plus x2 into, please wait, x2 into, how I can write vfg, that is vg2 minus vf2. So can I write this vg vfg into vg2 minus vf2? This is right or wrong? கொஞ்சம் லைட்டாக பிளர் ஆகுது பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் நெட்ஒர்க் கனெக்ஷன் தேர் இஸ் சம் பட் பிளரிங். ஸோ விஎஃப் ஜி டூ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு விஜி டூ மைனஸ் விஎஃப் டூ. ஆர் யூ ஓகே?
யெஸ் சார்.
யெஸ் சார்.
ஓகே, நவ ஐ கேன் எக்ஸ்பேண்ட் த ஃபார்முலா, தட் இஸ் விஎஃப், சாரி ஹியர் டூ ஐ கேன் ரைட் டூ. ஸோ விஎஃப் டூ பிளஸ் எக்ஸ் டூ இன்டூ விஜி டூ மைனஸ் எக்ஸ் டூ இன்டூ விஎஃப் டூ. Okay, so again I write that is the m into, I can take a vf2, that is conserve these two terms I write. So vf2 is a common, okay, that's why, so for vf2 I can take a common, so 1 minus x2 into vf2 plus I can say that is x2 into vg2. Are you okay? Because for the considering two terms, I take a vf2 as a common. So that's why 1 minus x2. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Can I understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Then, now, again, in some many cases of a thermodynamic systems in a pure substance, this term is neglected. This term is neglected. So why? Because compared to this term having a very much small quantity, 0.000 something, 0.000 something, we can get the answer. So that's why we neglect this term. So in many books of many thermodynamics books, you can answer, so unless this m2 into, that is x2 into vg2. Many cases can be written as x2 into vg2 because vf2 is negligible, very much low, and that multiplication 1 minus x2 we can get the very much low value. So that's why we neglect the whole term. Finally, we can get that is a m2 into, not a m2, m is remains same, so m into x2 into vg2. Okay. Now you can find the value of vg2. Now where you find the value of vg2? So at what condition you find the value of vg2? How you can find vg2? Listen. Here you know there is a v2. V2 is equal to m into x2 into vg2. Okay? Then, what about the value of V2? What is the value of capital V2? So in the previous paper, we find out that is the V1 is equal to V2 because we never take this system. So which is equal to, we never take any mass out from the system. So that's why V1 is equal to V2. So for that problem, I can write there is a V2 is equal to, say that is equal to 0.5619, otherwise you can take there is a 20, 11119, you can take 20 is equal to M into, that is X2 into VG2, X2 into VG2. Listen, then you already know mass and then x. So we need a Vg2. So Vg2 is equal to, listen, 0.5620 divided by mass. Already you know that is a mass is equal to 1.8 kg. Then dryness fraction, which is equal to 0.6, which can be written as that is Vg2 is equal to V2 divided by, so m into, that is x2. M into X2. So this is a formula for finding the value. From that value, finally we can get that Vg2 is equal to 0.625 meter cube divided by kilogram. 0.625 meter cube divided by kilogram. Okay. Then you know the condition of steam, I mean vapor at a position number 2. So what about the pressure and temperature of that condition? So only in the condition la vandu, so at that particular how we can find the pressure and temperature. So again, you pin the presentation screen. Here you can find what is the value of Vg is nearly equal to 0.625. Here you can find that. So listen, here the Vg, how it matches with the 0.625. Okay. So we have another one clue on the point. Initially, pressure is the condition of 5 bar. Then at a condition of saturated vapor, it reduces to the condition of x is equal to 0.6. So what happened inside? Whether it's a cooling or heating, what happened inside in a pressure cooker? Dryness fraction of x equal to 1 is reduced to x equal to 0.6. What happened inside? Whether cooling takes place or heating takes place?
Cooling.
Cooling. Very good. So cooling. Normally in the cooling takes place, what about the pressure? Whether pressure gets increased or decreased?
Decreased, sir.
So pressure gets decreased. So that's why we refer the value below 5 bar. Okay. Below 5 bar, because cooling takes place, if it is cooling takes place, definitely pressure gets reduced. So we searching the V values for the pressure below 5 bar. So below 5 bar, we search the V values. So we have a V value of 0.625. And exactly we are having a value of 0.625 at a pressure of say how much? At a pressure of say
2.9 bar.
Okay, now you can write the condition. So what is the pressure to then saturation temperature at a 2.9? What is saturation temperature? So what is the HF? Then what is the VF, then what is the VG. So you note the following values from the steam table. So pressure we can write is a 2.9 bar, then temperature it is equal to 132.4 degrees Celsius, HF is equal to 556.5 kilojoule per kilogram. HFG is equal to 2166.6 kilojoule per kilogram. VF is equal to 0.001072 meter cube per kilogram. Then VG is equal to, you know that is 0.625 meter cube per kilogram. So please, so I note the corresponding values at point number 2. Then I am going to calculate the internal energy at the point number 2. Now I am going to calculate the internal energy at point number 2. So how I can write the internal energy point? U2 is equal to, how I can write? U2 is equal to?
H2 minus P2 V2.
H2 minus, that is the P2, that is specific volume 2. Okay, H2 minus P2, specific volume 2. What about the H2? How I can write the H2? 2 is at which condition? Is it a saturated vapor or saturated liquid or mixer? 2 is at mixer. Which condition?
Mixer.
So how I can write the formula for mixer condition? What is the formula?
HD minus HF.
No. There is HF2 plus H2 into, there is HFG2. This is the formula to write the H2. So H2 is in a mixer condition. Okay? Are you understand? Now, I can write a P2 V2. So P2 already you know. So minus P2, how I can write a V2? How I can write V2? V2 also in the mix akkade now I can write V2
VF2 plus X2 into VFG
VF2 plus X2 into VFG2 I already told this is the elaborated formula for converting the vapor at a mixer phase okay this is the elaborated formula finally we are having a VF2 plus 1 plus X into VFG2 finally we reduce into V2 is equal to how we can write that is M into X2 into VG2. This is a formula for a V2. That is a sorry, M. That is M into something. We write this only for volume, specific volume. So here I can write P2 into V2 can be written as that is a simply X2 into VG2. Are you okay? Now I am asking one question at that point. If this term is multiplied by M, what about the value? If the term is multiplied by M, what is the value you got?
Total volume 2.
Total volume, very good. But now here we are not multiplied with the total. We are not. There is a put a value of total volume. Just see here, put the value of specific volume. So that's why X2 small VG2. So already you know here it is a pressure volume. Again, it has a conversion of meter cube. We can get the here the bar. It is a meter cube kilogram. Again, you can find or substitute the appropriate value of P2 that is equal to P2 that is equal to in terms of bar into kilogram newton per meter square. Then you substitute the appropriate values. So what is the HF2? We have in the here it can be write 2 suffix 2. I forgot to write 2. So HF2 plus X2. What is the value of X2? What is the value of X2?
0.6.
0.6. So if you write that is I write the formula that is a 556.5 plus 0.6 into HFD already you know there is a 2166.6. You have the one value minus here P2 is equal to 2.9. So 2.9 into 10 to the power of 2 for converting bar into kilonewton per meter square. So here 2.9 into 10 to the power of 2 kilonewton per meter square. Okay. Then substitute the X2 into VG2. So X2 is equal to 0.6 into VG2 0.625. You find that finally you can get the value of U2 is equal to nearly we are having U2 this is equal to 1747.7 kilojoule per kilogram. So here you find the value of U2. So in the previous steps you find the value of U1. Here the value of U1 is equal to 2560.17. But here you find the value of U2 is equal to 1747. So internal energy gets decreased. So yeah, internal energy gets decreased because of cooling. Now we are going to find how much heat is removed from the pressure cooker. So how much heat is removed from the pressure cooker? So listen. So here the heat removed, that is first you have to find the delta U. So that is the change in internal energy, that is U1 is minus, that is a U2. So already you find that U1 is equal to, that is a 2560 minus U2 is equal to 1747. So you are having the value change in internal energy is nothing but, so please wait. In some cases you have a value is nothing but that is, value is equal to 812 something. That is a 812 kilojoule per kilogram. Listen, if it's written in the simple form, you can be written like this. But the proper form, you write the delta U is. So change in internal energy is equal to final condition minus initial condition. This is a proper way to write the internal energy. For simple case, you have to write what is the delta U. But proper case, you have to write the final condition minus initial condition. So here, that is a 1747 minus 2560. Finally, you can get the answer of that is 812.813. Nearly 812 point something I get. exactly it is 813 something. So finally, minus 813 kilojoule per kilogram. What is the negative sign represent? What is the negative sign represent? So properly substituted the final value minus initial value, you get the negative value. What is the negative representation of negative value?
Heat rejected.
Heat
rejected or
heat rejected. So in the pressure cooker, so heat should be rejected to the surroundings. So yeah, that's why pressure gets reduced from P1 to P2. Pressure reduced. Temperature also reduced. P1 to P2. So because of cooling. So finally, you can write minus. Somebody says that the answer is in minus value. The problem is wrong. No, the problem is correct. The minus sign represents the heat is to be rejected. Finally, you can be right. That is a Q is equal to that is equal to M into. So you can write mass into that. How much heat is that is to be transferred is equal to mass into that is change in internal energy. How much kilojoule? So mass you already know that is equal to 1.5 into 813. So you need just nothing but kilogram into kilojoule per kilogram. Kilogram, kilogram gets cancelled. So finally we can be written as M is equal to, so how much heat is to be resulted is equal to minus 1 to, here you can written as a minus 1 to 18 kilojoule. That much amount of heat is to be rejected from a pressure cooker from the 5 bar to 2.9 bar. 5 bar to 2.9 bar reduction pressure cooker, we have that much amount of heat is liberated. Okay.